in my hand. Okay. That's fair enough. No, it isn't. Should I have some seeds in my hand? There has been an update. I'm gonna have to look back on things. This is slightly concerning, having nothing in my hand, but there you go. Anyway, where were we? Yeah, all this lot has started to be moved. We're starting the chicken farm, the Chickenator. And yeah, there's been quite a few changes around here. What do we have? I think. What the heck are you doing out? Who let you out? Who let the jerk out? Who let the jerk out? Right. That is not good. That is not good at all. Okay, so somehow we had an escaped chicken. It probably came through that glass opening. But we have the sum total of one egg. Okay, so let us move forth, and in case another one escapes, I'm doing that. We're probably going to go down south and come back through chicken country. So, yeah, things are working, things are running. Obviously, they're going to stop when we move out of here, but we are going to move south. Which means we're gonna need more planks, more stuff, more tools, more this, more that, more the other. Yeah. We're gonna need some more tools. I think I'm going to get rid of the iron pickaxe because I don't think we're gonna need it. Not where we're going. I will take some chests and a crafting table. Because you never know when you're going to need one of those. You never know when you need a crafting table. And I think that we shall leave the stone axe as well. Some of this stuff just might wind up if I do that and that. That'll get rid of the oak plank, so that'll save a bit of space. I do want another chest, however. Because what we're going to search for are a number of different things. We're going to be searching for another village. We're going to be searching for another. Well, we haven't come across another one yet, but we're going to be searching for one of those things, stand thingies that have the dynamite at the bottom of them. And we are also going to be searching for some sand because we're going to be running out of glass at some point. And if we can pick up some more chooks on the way, so much the better. So let us move south. And we need a bed. Da! Nearly went without a bed. Can't go anywhere without a bed. Yeah, need bed. Helps time move faster. Yeah, wibbly wobbly timey-wimey stuff. So, sally forth. With a bit of luck, when we get back, we'll find loads of bits and pieces. Yeah, southwards. No danger of coming across any chickens. Definitely not George. I called him George. Because I'm like that. Ooh, skeleton with armor. We'll have some of that. Will you drop any of it? That's the question. No, he didn't. Duh. Selfish skeletons these days. They just don't drop anything. They got all the good kit, but do they give any of it to you when they die? No. I reckon that we should make the mobs draft a will as to who gets their weapons and armor when they get slaughtered by an unscrupulous player. Right. So we have enough tools to make a few bits and pieces. South we go to where we last found a desert. So I'm not 100% sure what line we were on, but I'm pretty sure it was due south. So I'm going to do what I can to stay on the southern line. It's just gone 10:30, so I'm watching the clock so I don't bore people to smithereens this time. In fact, I should have departed with a shovel, because then I'd have been able to pick up some of this awkward, just lying there sand, begging to be sifted. The other thing I think I'll do is drop those arrows, because I don't think that we're going to have much of a cause for them. Yep. I'm going to wind up picking them up again, aren't I? Definitely going to need some more glass. Because let's face it, the chances of coming across one of our targets, let alone all three, are so slim as to be unbelievable. I mean, heck, I couldn't even find a chicken. And I couldn't even find a village in the snow. That was definitely a snow joke. I think I'm going to have to investigate getting a horse at this rate. I haven't made or captured and tamed a horse before, but I think there's probably going to have to be a first time for everything, because in single player, pretty much it's going to be a case of do what has to be done and cover large chunks of land relatively quickly. So I'm definitely going to have to investigate capturing myself a horse. Because pigs are bleeding useless, honestly. Show them a carrot and they're anybody's. Aren't you guys? Yeah. I could stop for some more sand, but I think I'd better press on and head south. I want to try and stay on the land as much as possible rather than swim in the water, because that'll save time. And apart from which, I didn't exactly bring my swimming trunks. Hello, pig. Yep, more of you. If I wasn't equipped with beef, I'd be after your curly little tails. I tell ya. The other thing that is down here is a swamp, and there were some nice blue flowers, and I wanted to try and pick some of those as well. Oh, sheep. I think somebody's weighted the chicken spawner. Not in my favour. There's more sheep to the left. I just saw it before I darted down here. Yeah. Blue flowers. Does that mean we're near a swamp? No, it just means that I'm looking through leaves and I can't tell the difference between blue flowers and water. Yeah. Duh. Hello, sheep. Why don't some of you guys... Isn't there a potion to turn sheep into chicken? Pink. Honest to goodness. I can find pink sheep, but I can't find chickens. What kind of game is this coming to? One of the mods that I do miss is the bird mod, the one that sent all those little twittering, tweeting birds around the place. That was quite nice. I do miss that. Yeah. I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to get back onto the dementia server with any kind of longevity, if that makes sense. Another pink sheep. What are you guys, breeding or something? No, don't tell me. I do not want to know. But the latest is that when I did tell Eclipse, okay, I'll pay the £200 plus VAT, just get somebody out here, their response was, and get this, they actually telephoned me, and they said, you know, I don't think it would be worthwhile getting an engineer out to you, so we're not going to bother. To a degree, I had to sort of grudgingly agree with them, because getting an engineer out to an intermittent fault is like, yeah. Yeah. He's trying to find a deal on Easter eggs before Easter is over. On the day after, no problem. Everything's half price. But you try and find a deal on Easter eggs before Easter? Ha! No chance. Okay, there is a village, and I believe that that is the village that we first encountered. So we are on course. We are definitely on course to find the other village. Thinking about it, I should have brought the zombie flesh that we've had so far in order to attempt to trade. Yeah, there's earth there, which means I've been here before. Ha! Ha. 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 Moo? What do you want to get in this conversation? Moo. Yeah, right. We can easily come back here for more food should we need it. But for now, we shall keep on heading southwards. We should come across that village at some point. We are running a bit low on food. Fortunately, there is another village down there, so we'll be okay. They'll have some wheat cooking, along with some potatoes and other stuff. Yeah, so I think we're going to be okay. Might as well get some more sand while we're here. Yeah, I feel like I should be coming up with some bumper stickers. Treat your Minecraft with care. Minecraft country, that is. I think I remember this point. The last time I was here, I took a sip from my tea and managed to drop... Oh, what was it? No, that was another location in the snow, I think. But it is starting to get dark. We need to set up for the night. Yeah. Ba ba da ba da ba da ba ba da ba da bum. No, I'm not going to go swimming in the nude. Despite not having my trunks. But we have encountered sand, which means that the second village is probably not too far away. There's a mountain over there to the left. So yeah, this village probably is not very far away. Probably just over that pile of sand, I suppose. If my memory serves me well, which typically it doesn't these days. Yay! Yes, village. have the village. Okay, that's been plundered, so what we'll probably do is follow the land round to the right. It's the old maze trick. If you want to know where you are in a maze, just keep your right foot to the wall and eventually you'll either find the exit or you'll be back where you were in the first place. So here we have a division between the sand and land. And we're going to follow this around. Yeah. So we should at least find the point at which we'll get a feel for how big this desert is. What the heck? Oh, and a bloke. Yeah, and a bloke. You can say that again. Did you hear that? Did you hear that? Yeah, zombie. Yep, sheeples. Any chickens? I want eggs. I want eggs. Yeah. I hate it when you get little lone sections of sand like that. It's as if they're a trap. Yes, everything underneath your feet is nothing, but you won't know unless you cause a block update, in which case... Oh, nothing happened. Okay, onwards, I guess. Yeah. Cause a block update and all the sand just vanishes from beneath your feet and you wind up staring face to face with a hiss boom as if the fall wasn't enough to do the damage. They hire a creeper to finish the job. Okay, we're starting to get somewhere now, I think. We're still heading south and the this is still going. Ooh. A village. Haha! Target one complete. Target acquired. Going in. Ah, by yourself. Oh, God. Is that all you guys ever say? Yes. Village. Do we have... Can't you guys actually lay your own steps? Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, I'll tell it to my audience. Large house. Hello. This village generation lock is... Whoa! You went straight through me! Oh! That chilled me to my bones. He just went straight through me. Yeah, nothing here. Nothing, 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 nothing. Hello, Mr. White. Librarian. Ooh, 31 paper for an emerald. Yes, books. This is what we want. That'll mean I can finish off the enchantment table. Because we've got 35 XP. And, yeah. This will mean we can use it all at last. We have books. We have learning. Yeah. Spider? I hear a spider. Ooh, he's actually thrown out the bad potato. Oh, that is cool. That is just so cool. Yeah. And I think that's pretty much the end of the village. They've got their wheat, which we'll take a chunk of. Thank you very much. Although I don't think that villagers actually eat per se, I do believe that they do distribute food. In other words, I don't think they die, but they do use it, and that encourages them to do other things. Oh, did I see that originally? I don't know. There's another hut over there. Yes, just a hut. Don't mind me, I'm just a hut. With grass growing in it. Yeah. No door in there even. So I think that if we head back to the librarian's house, we should be able to sort out the wheat. Which means if we give the seeds to a villager, possibly, or at least do the decent thing and plant them ourselves, I suppose. Might as well be good citizens, I suppose. I've noticed that we can still actually hear the clicking of the keyboard, even though it's browns. Now, one of the other keys that's come out for Cherry is an ultra-silent key. That's probably going to be a while before it makes it into half-decent keyboards. Okay, can we give the rest of these seeds to a villager? I wonder. Hey, Frank, you want some seeds? Did they take them? Yes, they actually took the seeds. That's cool. Yeah, let's get back to the desert, I think. There's a lot of it. Sheep eating again. Trog, trog, trog. Ah, wrong foot. I should be following the right foot. Now I'm following the left foot. No wonder I can't dance. But I can't see anything. Still, we've got one out of three, so this ain't bad. Well, sort of two out of three, because I can just take more sand. And then we're good to go. It's almost night time. Almost time to go sleepy bys. More desert horses. I'm going to have to look up how to tame a horse and to see how I care for it and ride it, bloody blah. Another pig. I'll call him George. Yeah. Ooh. They even rear up. I don't know if they did. Aw, a little foal. Oh, little fella. Yeah. I think I've got one wheat, but nah. It's coming up to night time. Let's get a few more blocks into the desert. It seems to be thinning out because we've got things at either side. So we're probably going to reach the tip of this desert in short order. So might as well get this done and return around the other way. Bit of a shame, but there you go. Ooh, orange. Yay! Yes! And another village. Ooh. Yay. Sorted. Sussed. Ho ho! Talk about a bonus! Okay. So, we are at a new day. Let's see what the village has to offer, shall we? A well out of water. That's a bit high, nobody can reach it. Ha! 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 Let's just fix a few of these. Bum, 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 bum. What do we have? Oh yes, more books. We can always do with books. Not that I ever get the time to read them in Minecraft, you understand? But yeah, books are one of those things that comes in handy. As are pickaxes, strangely enough. Yeah. So, we've actually got a chunk of work on now. 42 books, yeah, that's easy to carry. What do we have? Yeah, cool. We can come here and cook our gear. What do we have in the oh, diamonds, iron, bread. We can do with that some of that. And we might as well take the chest. We can come back and use these if we have to. We don't have any coal, which is a bit of a pain. But there you go. First step. Bump, bump. Drop the diamonds and valuable stuff in there. And we shall set the bed down, I think, because I think we're going to need it. And we shall go in with the earth. We'll leave the bread there. Okay. We shall go in. And as according to tradition with these, we don't go for the center. We go for one of these, which then takes us down without tripping off that plate. So we can get stuff out of the chests. A lot of bone. That's cool. That's actually quite cool. Now we can get at the TNT without setting it off. Yes! Bonus! Now, that's wanted is all this stone, which is the smart looking stuff, which means that we may actually have to come back on a second journey at some point. So we're going to need the chests as well. I really can't see why they haven't put backpacks in vanilla. It would be really good if they did. Come on, clunk. Thank you. Right. And we get away without causing a minor explosion. It's actually quite hard work taking one of these down. Okay. So what we're now going to do is go around as far as we can, just mining from the bottom. There's iron there as well, but I'm going to leave that. We're going to have too much to carry. We've already got a fair chunk. Right, now we start with the earth. In fact, I could take this floor up as well. There's always a danger with taking these floors up because you never know what's underneath them, and this illustrates that perfectly. There's a cave under there. Caves mean mobs. Let's get the stuff and get the heck out of here as soon as possible. Without wasting any torches. Okay, so we've got everything. We're now going to use some earth as a lift. I'm going to use it under here as well. That now gives us the ability to take all this without having a problem. The only problem I'm going to have is that I'm going to run out of pickaxe. This is odd. It's going back a bit. Now we have a load of decoration options. Yeah, this pick is nearly gone. So you can see how quick we're actually filling up with materials here. This could cause us a problem. So what we're going to do is now get out of here, make some more picks, and then come back down. Duh. Hello, Ender Pratt. Right, two emeralds. Where did I pick up the emeralds? I don't recall that. Anyway, we can set the chests down. Where are we going to do that? There, I think. And there. No, not there. There! Right. Okay, so we need the stone, we need the sticks, and we're going to need the crafting table for our makeshift. Tool thingy. Okay, let's go down and start to finish the job. Right. I definitely want all of the colored stuff. Ooh. Haha. You nearly fooled me, you block of cobblestone, you. Okay. Drat. Okay. Oh. Missed the purple one. And we're actually going to be running short of earth at some point as well. Like now. Ah, brother. D- Don't you just hate it when a plan doesn't come together? And we're starting to come to night. So we need more earth. Right. Let's just dump that. Dig some earth from somewhere. We need the shovel. And there's not much in the shovel, even. Right. This is really epic music. Really suiting the task at hand, I don't think. Oh boy, you gotta love it. Oh well, so much for caring the environment. I can see my house from here. Well, not really. 26 should do the job, I think. Yeah, given the gravitas of what we've found, I think it's probably going to take a while. We are currently 3/4 hour into this game. We'll dump that. And we'll put the sand down. Yeah, we're going to take to this level, I think, all told. So, let's get up the top and let's get mining. Starting at the top, of course, allows more light in, which helps cut down the mob spawn when we really start to get this moving. I've determined my floor level. Whoops! And we're just gonna wind up going through pickaxes like there's no tomorrow. It's probably gonna take multiple trips to get all this back to base. So I might do a Yakety Sax impersonation to get them back. Yeah, da 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 da. Oh, that was weird. I'm listening to myself in the headphones, and because I am, there's a very slight delay. When I do anything fast speech, I interfere with myself, and I can't control what I'm saying. That probably doesn't make any sense whatsoever, but I know what I mean. There's lava over there as well, so we better be careful with how we deconstruct this. There's quite a lot of blocks in this thing, so yeah, let's now open it up. Trying to make these blocks manually in single player when you've got no mods to help you out in vanilla is not the easiest. So, yeah. We'll just use this to get down in there and collect these blocks before they despawn. Bink, bank, bonk. Got them. Alright, I see. Okay, it's like that, is it? It's going to take a number of trips to get all this stonework back. Plus, we've got the books. I'm toying with the idea of just leaving a ruin. But nah. Should now have enough to completely disassemble the place, I hope. You know, part of the fun of this is working out what I'm going to call these videos. I think this one will probably be called after a film called Short Circuit. No disassemble. No disassemble number 5. Number 5 is alive. Yeah, unlike my sense of humor, which is totally dead. Right, okay, so we're getting this place really sorted out now. We're doing the number. That's one thing about single player, you haven't got to worry about anybody coming after you and falling into your pit holes. I think that the open area is possibly the easiest to disassemble. My luck changed. We've got sand, we have villages, and we've got the books, and now we've got a temple. Brilliant. Glad that when you've processed stone like this, that it doesn't deteriorate to something more basic. That really is a bonus. But colors are difficult in single player to maintain. I mean, you can get them, yeah, but getting them in quantity and reliable to do any decent work, you are a bit limited. The bone thing, the bone meal thing, was a definite plus in that regard. I think we've got to go to sleep. I can't really sleep at night. No kidding. Ooh, standstill stairs. Now I think we're pretty much down to the Twin Tower assembly. Then that's it, I think. What are you doing, Ender Pratt? Yay, I've made him angry. But he can't get to me. Oh dear, what a shame. You can't get to me, can you? Ender Pillock. Yeah. We'll have this finished in no time, I think. Then we'll find out whether Endermen really are like elephants, whether they never forget. Yeah, we're getting there. That's the problem with a lot of this grinding stuff. It is just grind to achieve this. Okay. This is pretty much one tower down, one to go. And then I think we're going to be heading our way home. Got to see how much of this we can carry. Was that noise? Does anybody know what that noise was? I hear it every now and then, but yeah. I should have counted how many picks it's taken to destroy this. Duh. very nearly there. Watch this video back and see how many axes, how many picks it's taken. Yay! We've done it! We've done it! Hurrah! Now, we need some food. Fast! Ah, we still have steak there. I think we can leave the steak. I'll take the bone. Nothing in there. Nothing in crafting. We'll take the colored, the book, the iron, the diamond, the chest, the sword we will need. We'll leave the wheat, we'll leave the coal, we'll take the TNT. We don't need the pressure plates. I think that's about it. Yep, that looks to be about it. We can obviously use the pickaxes and take some of the sandstone. And we can come back for this at a later stage. We are going to need the bed, however. Right, north is that away, I believe. One thing that I want to do also is decimate some of this area. I want some of this iron grid at some point. So what I'm probably going to do... Her. What do you mean, her? Of course I'm leaving. Don't worry, I'll be back. Honest. Oh, they've come out to see me off. Don't worry, I'm coming back. At this point, I'll probably leave you guys with some music as I try and head back to base. Just gotta hope I can find this place again. See you in a minute.